Hi, welcome back. I'm Dr. Robert Lupo, MD, and I'm a board-certified orthopedic surgeon. And today we're going to discuss what is a hip replacement. First is my disclaimer. This is an educational informational video. It is not to be construed as medical advice. The information is not intended to replace the medical advice offered by your physician, so please, discuss your medical conditions with your doctor before making any decisions in regards to your health care. Okay, so what is a hip replacement? Basically, a metal stem will go in the femur, and to that metal stem, a ball is attached. A metal cup goes into the socket, and then a liner will be put into the cup. Both have a porous surface that will grow, the bone will grow into, and the action is all where the ball and the liner come together. And I'm going to show some pictures, and we're going to go over all this. All right, so here we are. This is a drawing that I did. I'm not a fantastic artist. That's why I'm a surgeon and not not showing galleries. But basically, this would be your belly button. This is your pelvis. This is your femur bone. This is your other femur. This would be the side of your leg at your hip. I know we talked earlier that the hip joint's actually in the groin. This would be your groin crease right here. Okay? All right. So this is the area we're focusing on for the hip. All right. So we're going to go to the next slide. All right. So when you do a hip replacement, here's the ball. Here's the socket. The red is meant to show inflammation. When you do hip surgery or hip replacement, you simply cut the bone of the hip right here and you remove the ball. So you're left basically with just a neck. This is called the neck of the femur and the whole femur. And then you're left with a socket. Okay? Remember, there's two sides to every joint. This is the socket side, and this is the ball side. Well, we cut the ball out, so how are we going to put a new ball on there? Well, there's nothing really here. So basically what you have to do is you have to put a stem. This green represents the stem that will go down the bone, and then what we will do is attach a new ball to that stem. And on the other side, what we do, the black represents the metal cup, and then the yellow represents the liner. Okay, I think it was like a trash can, you put the garbage bag on inside, that's the liner. So this liner actually snaps into this socket. And then basically a ball will attach to this stem. Okay, so the things that change in regards to hip replacement, in regards to the properties of a hip replacement, are primarily involve the ball and the liner, because those things pop in and out. Those are interchangeable. The stem, once it's grown into bone, and the cup that's grown into bone, those do not come out easily. Now, there's a lot in the marketplace now that will talk about a special approach to the hip. Well, we do a minimally invasive approach, or we do a mini posterior approach, or I do an anterior approach, I use a special bed to do the approach. All of them have their advantages and disadvantages. The most important thing, no matter what happens and how it's approached, the only thing that's important is that the implant's placed properly. In other words, I could say, oh, I can build your house in 3 days, but if I don't build it properly, then it's not going to last. And when we do joint replacement surgery, we want these to last as long as possible. And they have to be properly aligned, because the alignment of these implants is very important. Just like the alignment in your car tires, and you know, when you get a front end alignment for your car, so your tires will ride evenly and smoothly and not on the edges, which will increase wear. Well, the same thing happens with the hip replacement. If it's not put in properly, you're going to have increased wear. That wear can cause the implant to loosen, can cause it to fracture, can cause it to dislocate. So all is very important. The only thing that's important is that your doctor gets the components in the proper alignment. However approach he does it, is relevant, but it's the least important part of the replacement. And sometimes I think the patient gets hung up on, well, how is this going to be done? Because I hear this approach is easier to recover from. Well, you're looking at a joint replacement that will hopefully last you 15, 20, 30 years even. So if you're looking at a replacement that you're looking for longevity, I think the most critical thing is that it's put in appropriately. Now, there's some advantages of all these and disadvantages. The posterior approach is probably the most common. Low complication rate, less limp. When it's done properly, there's no increased risk of dislocation. But the one thing is true, higher rate of limb lengthening. Okay? So anterolateral, they have a limp postoperatively. They can have bone develop in the muscle called heterotopic bone. And one of the new approaches is this anterior approach. But there's a higher risk of femur fracture, injury to the muscle controlling the nerves around the femur, and it requires live x-ray, which may help with component positioning. That's yet to be seen. And questionably faster recovery. With the pain management protocols that we use nowadays, the patients are recovering quite fast. So this is what a hip replacement looks like. There's a stem, a ball, and a socket. And then on the inside of the socket is the liner. So this is a case I did. This is a gentleman with bad arthritis of his hip. You can see bone on bone. If you watched the What is Arthritis video earlier, you'll be able to see that this cartilage is completely gone, and this is a replacement. Okay, here's a stem. The stem is titanium. The cup is titanium. And this is actually a ceramic head on cross-linked polyethylene. And we'll go over all the different implants later on, but this is basically a high-performance bearing. And there's bilateral hip replacements. This guy's both his hips done. But this is what these look like. For my contact information or more videos, go to drrobertlupo.com. We will be presenting a number of videos on hip replacement. This is not the only one. So watch the videos in order, and I appreciate your attention.